Hi, I'm Jeff Bowler, a program manager in the Intune product group, and this session is Intune for Education Enrollment. There are two types of Windows enrollment for Intune for Education: self-service enrollment and bulk enrollment. Self-service enrollment is when a user would manually go through the process of enrolling their device, and bulk enrollment is when you'd have an IT staff that'd be enrolling multiple devices, maybe hundreds or thousands of Windows devices. Let's take a look at each one of these. Let's look at the different options for self-service enrollment. The first option you have is for the Windows out-of-box experience. When you first power on a new device, you'll be going through the Windows out-of-box experience and be prompted to enter in your credentials. You can enter in your Azure AD credentials, and this will automatically enroll your device into Intune for Education. The other option is post-Windows out-of-box experience, where you can go into Windows settings in Accounts, Access Work, or School, and select Connect, and enter in your Azure AD credentials, and that will automatically enroll your Windows device into Intune for Education. And then you also have an option using the Intune company portal, either the native Windows app or the web app, and you can follow the instructions to enroll your Windows device into Intune for Education. Now let's look at some options for bulk enrollment. You have two options: using Setup School PCs app or the Windows Configuration Designer application. The Setup School PCs app was designed for education. It's a free app that's in the Windows Store, and it creates a provisioning package that would be installed during the out-of-box experience. It does a Azure AD join. It does some customization for the start menu and taskbar, specifically for education. It will automatically configure the device for education, and it can automatically install some selected applications. Now, Windows Configuration Designer is also a free app in the Windows Store. It creates a provisioning package that's used to install during the out-of-box experience. But besides just doing an Azure AD join, it can also do an Active Directory join or create a local admin account. The settings are more customizable in a Windows Configuration Designer. It also allows you to upgrade the OS version and install apps from the Windows Store for Education, desktop apps, and even install certificates. Let's now do a walkthrough of the Setup School PCs application. We're currently in the Setup School PCs application, and you can see it's explaining the different steps that you would go through to create a provisioning package. We're going to first choose preferred settings and apps for student PCs. We're then going to save this provisioning package on one or more USB drives. And then during the out-of-box experience, we're going to plug in the USB drive and the provisioning package will be installed on the PC. So it's a pretty straightforward process. Let's go ahead and click Get Started. The first step of the process is signing in with your school's O365 account. So I'll select Sign In. And I'll enter in my administrative account. And select Next. I'll then enter my password and click Sign In. All right, now that I've signed in, I'll select Next. And here I'm going to choose a Wi-Fi network. And this is important because we want to select a Wi-Fi network that we can connect to once we're installing the provisioning package. So I'm going to select this guest network and enter in a security key. And the network has been verified. So we'll select Next. And here we're in the settings page. So this is where we can configure different PC settings. For instance, we can select apps that were pre-installed. We can also have a selection of whether it allow for local storage. And then we can optimize the device for single student use, and then also let guests sign in to this PC. So we'll accept all the defaults, and then you can see that we have a default screen background that we'll keep. So we'll select Next. We also have an option that will create a Take a Test button, and this is for the Take a Test application that's in Windows 10 for high-stakes testing. We'll go ahead and select no for now and select next. And then we have an option to install applications from the Microsoft Store. And we'll go ahead and skip this for now. So here's a summary of our selections. We signed in with this particular admin account. Our wireless network is going to be CMGuest. We're accepting the default settings, and we've disabled Take a Test. And now we'll select Accept. Now, the USB drive that you use has to have at least 109 megabytes available of storage, and we've already entered in, inserted our USB flash drive, and I'll select that and click Save. All right, our package is now saved, and you notice that it provides you a package name and then also has an expiration date about 30 days from this date, so this is important. And we'll talk more about that, but take a note of that when you're creating this provisioning package. And we can remove the USB drive now if we want, and then we can also add additional USB drives to copy this provisioning package file onto. But we're good for right now, and we'll select Next. And then this is going through and showing you the process of how you would use this provisioning package and install it on new student PCs. So it provides some guidance about lining up the students, and then having them turn on their PC, and then waiting for the boot up for the operating system to get to the Let's Start with Region, is this right? And once you see that screen, then you would insert the USB drive into the PC, and it would automatically recognize it and install the provisioning package. It would then go ahead and restart the Windows PC. The PC would be ready then for the students to use. So I provided some additional information on Intune for Education enrollment, adding devices to Intune for Education, use setup school PCs and Windows configuration designer links that you can review. This now ends the session on Intune for Education enrollment.